Every Whoville liked Christmas a lot.
But the Grinch who lived just north of Whoville did not.
The Grinch hated Christmas the whole Christmas season.
Now please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason.
It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right.
It could be perhaps his shoes were too tight.
But I think the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was too sizes too small.
But whatever the reason, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve hating the news.
Staring down from his cave with the sour Grinchy from at the warm lighted window below in their town, where he knew every who down and who will be neat with busy now, maybe a mistletoe wreath.
In their hanging stockings.
He snarled with a sneer.
Tomorrow's Christmas Eve, practically here.
Then he growled with his Grinchy and window. Then he growled with his Grinchy fingers nervously drumming.
I must find some way to stop Christmas from coming.
For tomorrow noon, all the little girls and boys would wake bright and early. They'd rush for the toys and then
the noise.
That's one thing he hated, the noise.
Noise.
Then the Whos, young and old, would sit down to a feast.
And they feast.
Feast.
They would feast on Who pudding and rare Who roast beef,
which was something the Grinch couldn't stand at the least. And then they'd
he liked least of all.
Every rebound in Whoville, tall and small, would stand close together with Christmas brandy. They'd stand hand in hand.
And Whos would start singing.
They'd sing.
And they'd sing.
And they'd sing.
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 Stop.
I must stop this whole thing. Why, for 53 years I've put up with it now. I must stop this Christmas from coming. But how?
Then he got an idea.
An awful idea.
The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea.
I know just what to do.
The Grinch
laughed
in his throat.
And he
knew
a quick
and he chuckled and clucked.
What a great Grinchy trick with this coat and this hat. I look just like St. Nick. All I need is a reindeer.
The Grinch looked around but sent. Since reindeer are scared, there was none to be found.
Did that stop the Grinch?
No.
The Grinch simply said,
if I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead.
So he called his dog Max.
Then he took some red thread and he tied a big horn on top of his head. Then he loaded some bags
and some old empty sacks
on a ramshackle sleigh,
and he hitched up old Max.
Then the Grinch said,
giddy up.
And the sleigh started down towards the Whos, where the Whos lay a snooze in their town.
All their windows were dark, quiet snow filled the air.
All the Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without food.
When he came to the first little house on the square,
this is stop number one.
The old Grinchy claws his.
And he climbed to the roof, empty bag from his fist.
Then he slid down at the chimney.
A rather tight pinch.
But if Santa could do it,
then so could the Grinch.
He got stuck. Only
only one short-ray moment.
Then he stuck his head out of the fireplace flue, where the new stockings all hung in a row.
The stockings.
He grinned.
Are the first thing to go.
Then slithered and swung with a smile most unpleasant.
Around the whole room, any place ever present.
Pop guns, bicycles, roller skates,
drums,
checkboards, tricycles,
popcorn,
and plums.
And he stuffed them in bags. Then the Grinch very nimbly stuffed all the bags, one by one, up the chimney.
Then he slunk to the icebox.
He took the loose feet.
He took the loose pudding.
He took the roast beef.
He cleaned out that icebox as quick as a flash.
Why, the Grinch even took their last can of food pants.
Then he stuffed all the food up the chimney with glue.
And now,
from the Grinch,
I will stuff up the tree.
And the Grinch grabbed the tree and
the Grinch had been caught by this tiny Who daughter who'd got out of bed for a cup of water.
She stared at the Grinch and said,
Santa Claus, why? Why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why?
But you know, the old Grinch was so smart and slick, he thought up a lie.
He thought it up quick. Why, my sweet little tot.
Fake Santa Claus.
There's a lit light on this tree that won't light on one side, so I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, then I'll bring it back here.
And this big fool.
Then he patted her head and he got her a drink and he sent her to bed.
And then Cindy Lou Who went to bed with her cup. He went to the chimney and stuffed up the tree.
Then the last thing he took was the log for their fire. Then he went up the chimney himself, the old liar.
On their walls, he left nothing but hooks and some wire.
And the one speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse.
It was quarter past dawn.
No.
Not still.
Did the same thing to the other Who's houses.
Leaving crumbs much too small for the other Who's mouses.
It was quarter past dawn.
All the Who's still of it.
All the Who's still is news.
Trimmings,
the tapping,
the 3,000 feet up the side of Mount Crumpet.
He rode with his lap, rode to the top, tippy top, if to dump it.
Boo,
boo, to the hooves.
He was graciously humming.
They're finding out now that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up. I know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open a minute or two, and the Who's down in Whoville will all cry, boo-hoo, that's a noise.
Grinned the Grinch.
That I simply must hear.
So he paused, and the Grinch put his hand to his ear, and he did hear a sound rising over the
started out low. Then it started to grow.
The sound wasn't sad.
Why this sound suddenly sounded merry?
It could be so,
but it was merry.
Very.
He stared down at Pluto.
He shook.
What he saw was shocking surprise.
Every who doubted who Bill was tall and small was thin.
Without any presents at all.
He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming.
Somehow or other, it came just the same. And the Grinch with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow
stood puzzling and puzzling.
How could it be so? It came without ribbons, it came without tags, it comes without patches, boxes, or bags.
And he puzzled for hours till his puzzler was sore.
Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before.
Maybe Christmas.
He thought.
And what happened then?
Shh. Doesn't come from stars. Maybe Christmas perhaps means a little bit more.
And then what happened then? Well, in Whoville they say that the Grinch's small heart beat three sizes that day.
And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load through the bright morning light.
And he brought back the toys.
And the food for the feast.
And he
himself.
The Grinch Carl's Rose Beast.
Scripted by Chase Young.